Hello everyone and welcome to Copacabana Beach in Rio de Janeiro for the final of the women's beach volleyball competition. After 53 matches, it comes down to this, a battle between Germany and Brazil to see who will be the champions of Rio 2016. Laura Ludwig and Kira Valkenhorst, the number 4 seeds from Germany, are the reigning European champions, and they have already made German beach volleyball history by securing their country's first women's medal in the sport. Agatha and Barbara of Brazil, the number 2 seeds, are the reigning world champions and are looking to win their country's second gold and the first since beach volleyball was first introduced into the games in Atlanta in 1996. It will be Brazil's first gold medal match since Athens in 2004. It is a packed stadium here in Copacabana, and the atmosphere is absolutely rocking.
There's so much to be said for these iconic stands. It's deep and it's fast, and that's exactly how the players like it. Anybody who plays beach volleyball at an extremely high level has played here in Rio. There was an FIVB Grand Slam stop earlier this year here in Copacabana as an Olympic qualifying event, and now the main stage is set and it's lightning in a bottle.
So the women's gold medal match pits Laura Ludwig and Kira Valkenhorst of Germany up against Agatha and Barbara of Brazil. That is Laura Ludwig just walking off the screen wearing number 1 for Germany. What a tournament she has had in the backcourt for her team. But with Brazil in the mix, the atmosphere here is going to be absolutely incredible. They love beach volleyball in these parts. There are beach volleyball courts littered all the way down Copacabana and round the corner into Ipanema, and people play from dawn till dusk. It may have been invented in the United States, but its home is now most definitely in Rio.
There's so many people that enjoy the sport, both playing at all different ages and sizes and shapes and organizations, whether it's indoor or beach, whether you got 2 people on the court or whether you got 30 people on a side, it is fun to be had by all. And it takes an entire village. Everybody here is so invested in the sport. They care for it, they love on it. And that's why it's a party. That's why it's such a gathering of wonderful friends and family. You got everything from the DJ starting the party to the referees and them doing an incredible job this entire tournament, to the volunteers. It's an incredible setting.
Okay, so let's introduce you to the 2 referees. The first referee from Spain, Jose Maria Patron. And the second referee from Russia, Roman Pristovakin. Big moment for these 2 gentlemen as well, taking charge of the Olympic Games final.
Once you get to this stage, you are the best in the business in whatever capacity, but it's going to be a blast tonight.
Beach volleyball, 3 times Olympian, 4 times European champion, now ready for the final at the Olympics. Bring it on for number 1, Laura Ludwig.
Laura Ludwig, as we've mentioned, will be defending the backcourt. 1.81 meter in height, 5'10". 133 tournaments, 8 career wins, 7 of them on the FIVB World Tour.
6 final fours this season. Player with number 2, representing Germany, 1.84 meters tall, Kira Valkenhorst.
And Kira Valkenhorst, as you heard, 1.84 meter or 6 foot, comes onto the court. She will be doing the blocking. They had an outstanding semi-final against the number 1 seeds, Talita and Larissa of Brazil. And their opponents are the number 2 seeds from Brazil. And listen to this for a welcome.
Campeã do mundo, a mulher gato, a
Agatha, 1 meter 82, 6 foot. She will be doing the blocking.
3 de agosto de 1987, nascia a única atleta a ser campeã do mundo em todas as categorias, porque ela é bárbara, ela é bárbara, ela é bárbara! Seixa!
And her partner, number 2, Barbara, 178 or 5'10", will be doing the defensive work in the backcourt, the reigning world champions from The Hague last year. So, the teams are out. Let's have the national anthems of both countries. Germany's will be first and then Brazil's. That is the weight of expectation upon the shoulders of Agatha and Barbara. They have waited long, the Brazilian public, for a beach volleyball gold medal in the women's competition, and this is expected. Two sides on the court that are probably in the best condition ever, and also two so tightly knitted groups of players. Agatha and Barbara, firm friends on and off the court. Valkenhorst and Ludwig have become inseparable. And it's Germany that get this gold medal match underway, playing from left to right in the black outfits. And it is Brazil that get the first point in the semi-final win over April Ross and Kerry Walsh Jennings. The Brazilian pair were under all sorts of pressure, but they seemed to thrive on it. They played phenomenally well to come through 22-20, 21-18. But on the other side of the net is a German pair that absolutely dismantled the number one seed. It is one of the most impressive displays we've ever seen on a beach volleyball court, and it is two teams that are worthy of a place in the gold medal match.
No doubt about it. Both these teams battled fiercely through the semifinal matches, beating some of the most incredible teams in the world. The Brazilians, Agatha and Barbara, just were unstoppable. There was nothing Team USA could do that had an answer. Germany was surgical. They were so clean and so precise with everything that they did. And that's why both these teams are here tonight.
What a block. And the key here for the German pair is to get into this game quickly and just try and quieten the crowd. Every Brazilian point is going to be cheered to the heavens.
Agatha and Barbara have definitely fed off the energy of the crowd. Doesn't necessarily seem to bother the Germans too much, as they had to go through the favorites, Larissa and Talita. It looks like there's a lot of wind picking up here in the stadium. You can tell by Laura's hair, they're blowing. They're on what would be quote unquote the bad side with the wind at their back. Brazil's on what we would consider the good side with the wind in their face. It just makes the ball more unpredictable, and it allows the Brazilians to stay pretty aggressive in their serving on that side of the net.
Well, Valkenhorst repays the block of Agatha to level it up at 3-all. If you are watching beach volleyball for the first time, I want a quick reminder of the rules. It's best of three sets. The first two sets are played to 21. See this seventh point played out, and it goes the way of Brazil. And now, because 7 points have been played, there's going to be a court switch, and that will happen every multiple of seven. And first to 21. If you get to 20, all there have to be two clear points. And there are also two challenges per team per set. Of course, if you get your challenge right, you keep it. If you get it wrong, you lose it. Good dig from Ludwig, plunging forward.
So what got the side switch for Brazil in their favor was a net fault by Kiara Valkenhorst. That net also can start to blow and cause it to go into the blocker. So something that all these players are taking into account. But we're also looking at a stadium that seats 12,000. So not only is it one side might be more favorable, but it can, that wind can bounce around and create some serious swirling action down there on the court.
This wind has got up since the bronze medal match, which finished, well, maybe an hour and 20 minutes ago. See the flags there and the towel of the line judge and the ball boy in the background. That's a heavy set from Ludwig. And they've got away with this of Germany, although the advantage still with Brazil. Good block from Valkenhorst. Oh, what a rally. What a rally.
Really great work on both sides of the net. Staying calm, staying patient. That first set by Laura Ludwig was aggressive, but she's got to get it up into the wind. Knowing how physical Kiara Valkenhorst is, she likes her chances getting up there and tangling with Agatha in the block.
What an atmosphere to play in. That's another feature of Lara Ludvig. She's very happy to put the ball back over the net, first or second touch. She likes to change it up.
She is known for that, those type of plays. It's most definitely in the Brazilian scouting report. Watch for Laura to go on one, watch her to go on two. They are very, very precise in the way they score.
It's been missed, the cut shot. So six all.
Just hammering into the wind.
That was the wind. You can hear it on the effects mics. You can see it in the crowd. Look at this, just die.
So she created a little bit of a hybrid there with that serve. That's usually her jump float serve. She put a little extra on that last one, putting a spin on it, and she's there.
Well, digging at all angles is Ludvig, but in the end, just couldn't keep it alive. Gets there, Falkenhorst can't keep it up. Good reactions, and in the end they go at the retreating Falkenhorst, who can't do anything about the power from Agatha.
Agatha hammering, and Falkenhorst is not, but maybe a meter and a half, 2 meters away.
First faults from the service line in the match. Oh, nice work from Ludvig.
Her patience and precision is what sets her apart.
Oh, good dig. Oh, well done. Really well done. Plunging forward is Barbara to keep that alive.
Saving an ace. What a get. And then Babara, very much a pokey, chippy type of player. She's going to place it before she wants to swing at it.
Falkenhorst into the empty backcourt.
This team has not seemed rattled once. This entire tournament, this entire Olympics, the Germans have been steady, they've been focused. It's been point by point, side by side for them.
Off the block, out of play, 10-0.
And that type of focus and that type of calm can only come from trusting each other and trusting the work that you've put in, trusting the team that's behind the team, the team in the stands, the sports psychologists, the nutritionists, the strength coaches, the video analysts. There's a lot of trust in that camp, and it's paying off for them.
So the first technical timeout, it is Germany that lead by a solitary point, 11-10. And this gold medal match just couldn't be any closer. Each side also has the timeout that they can take.
So that was the first side that was won on what would be considered the bad side. Everybody has won. Both of these teams, both Germany and Brazil, started the set by winning the right side of the court to your screen when it gets to that higher vantage point. That was the first time that Germany won the bad side.
So this is the view from the helicopter looking at Copacabana and out onto sea, and the wind is coming from left to right, down the beach from the left to the right, which is a change because this entire tournament has been coming the other way from Ipanema, from right to left. So a bit of a change for the players. They don't care. They're watching beach volleyball, the fans.
And it is howling. If we can see the wind and that flag whipping down on the sand, you can imagine what it's doing up in the nosebleeds. What a serve by Walkenhorst. She's taking full advantage of that wind being in her face. That allows her an extra meter, so to speak, to play with. She can hit that ball that much harder because she knows the wind is going to pull it. It's going to be a bit of a string that'll pull it back for her.
Agatha rolls it.
But both of these sides, extremely experienced players. They are true professionals. They're not afraid of the wind. A lot of times the wind can cause some mental fatigue because you're always thinking about it. You'll see the players kick the sand in the air, see which direction it's actually blowing. And so they're always playing with it rather than against it. So both of these sides, both of these teams, extremely good at making the wind their friend.
I think we're going to have a challenge here. Valkenhorst thought it was wide. He was certainly talking to the first referee. Whether or not we get a challenge, he might have gone across to have a look at the sand before making the mark. It's very close.
From that angle, it looked like it bounced the line.
No challenge. Definitely an ask from Valkenhorst. 12 all.
The Germans getting a little bit too aggressive with their setting. They definitely are looking to stay aggressive, but sometimes you got to walk a fine line.
Brazil have just won this, well, they're 3-1 up in this set of seven from that left-hand side. Again, they go aggressive. Was that a net touch? It was by Brazil.
The Germans have been working on a very high set from the beginning of the year. It got a little squirrely, but they stuck with it. They stuck with it and trusted it. And over time, it's paid off.
Although this wind will make that high set very difficult to judge. Valkenhorst, good block.
Exactly. But Kiera Valkenhorst, when she can put her hands on it, it comes out so clean. It's very, very pretty.
So 3-all in this set of seven.
Ludwig going for that same serve that got her an ace earlier in this set.
The cut shot gives them the side, and they extend their lead to 2, 15-13.
Valkenhorst has one of the heaviest arms in the game. That's why it's kind of taped on right now. It's taken a lot of swings. There's only so many bullets in that gun, but I believe she has a few rounds left in her.
Timeout call by Brazil just to try and take a sting out of the game. Sixth time, these two have met since June last year. And Ludwig and Valkenhorst lead the series by 4 matches to 1. Agatha and Barbara won the first one as we see the draw of how they got to this gold medal match. Agatha and Barbara won the first one in June last year in Stavanger, but then Ludwig and Valkenhorst won in Yokohama. They won in the pool match in the Swatch FIVB World Tour Finals. They won in the World Tour Final semi-final, and they won in the gold medal match in Hamburg. So the last four matches going the way of the Germans. The last two, incidentally, have gone to three sets. Big block.
It's very difficult to deal with the southpaw, to deal with the lefty, but Kiara Valkenhorst did an incredible job at lining up on her shoulder and not giving Barbara any space at all. Wow, that is such a great and gutsy adjustment by the Germans. Knowing that Barbara likes to get chippy, that's not a mistake she makes. But Germany talked her into it.
That's going to have too much on it. Oh, she's played it, Laura Ludwig. She didn't need to. Oh,
wow.
Wow. That is a let off for Brazil. That was going miles out. It's the wind, though, that's made Ludwig play that. Because she thinks the wind is blowing this back in.
Unless she got interesting information from Kiara Valkenhorst, who has to serve as her eyeballs. But in a situation like that, you play anything close. We're in a gold medal match. The thing that takes the wind out of your sails faster than anything is letting a ball like that go and having it drop on the line.
Well, she doesn't let it affect her.
Great mental agility by Lotta Ludwig to come back and take care of business.
Rolls it over the attempted block.
Just a bit outside.
Brazil need to start winning points on their serve here. Good dig. Very good dig from Brazil. Another excellent dig. Back pedaling goes Valkenhorst, but it's straight at Ludwig. Ludwig! Net violation, I think, is it? It's gone the way of Brazil.
Wow, they both aggressively went in for it and they both celebrated just as equally aggressive, so it's hard to tell.
Touch the arm. I think it's the arm that just touches the top of the net.
Ludwig was definitely the aggressor on that. But Germany still being very, very aggressive with their setting. That's the follow.
That's the one she leaves. And it gets them to within 2 points of this first set. The crowd know the importance. These next few points. Oh, that's an important spike.
Great play by the Brazilians. That's how they started their semifinal match against Kerry Walsh, Jennings, and April Ross. Was really good ball control and serve receive, and then running back plays, going behind the setter and spreading the defense as far as they can. Makes the defense extremely uncomfortable.
Oh, good dig. Valkenhorst pounces to bring up 3 set points.
Stays in the play, stays as the aggressor. It's a much different feeling when a team takes a court and they're looking to score and they are the aggressors.
Long from Valkenhorst, but the next set point comes on the Brazilian serve. But the next two, if they require them, will both be on the Brazilian serve. And they take the first set at the second time of asking. And Germany are in front in this gold medal match, and the pocket of German supporters rises one to cheer. And listen to how quiet the stadium is now. We mentioned at the top of the match that what the German pair needed to do is to get into the match and quieten the crowd. They've done that in the first set because they've won it 21-18.
They have been extremely consistent.
So here are the first set stats, and well, just swung in the middle of that set when Brazil took the 7 points on that left-hand side of the court. Set two then, Germany leading by a set to nil, having taken the first at 21-18. There she goes.
That is her on one. That is her jam, and she loves it. Opponents despise it. Just great positioning, and it's flat enough and fast enough. She really stays behind the ball well. Her shoulders are textbook.
Oh yes, hang time from Valkenhorst.
What a great read, a step in, a bit of the delay on the ground, knowing that she might want to be shooting. And just outreaches. And the finish, it's one thing to touch it, it's something else to finish it and throw it down.
2-0 Germany. Cross court, Brazil are on the board in the second set.
Trying to take some sort of momentum, trying to figure out how they're going to get these points against a very, very tough German team. Blasting. Again, Valkenhorst, not only does she have such a heavy arm, but she can hand set, which is an extremely difficult skill for the women.
Oh yeah, she's there again.
Those are the details that separates a gold medal team from the rest of the world. It happens in the fingertips.
Again, she seems to hang there for ages. Well, they've got the early advantage here, have Germany, but that's just it. It's an early advantage. Plenty of time for Brazil to try and fight their way back into this. A little change on the set going around the back, but the dig is from Ludwig, and she puts away the spike. Oh my word, this is almost a repetition of the semi-final. Except in the semi-final, they were down three quarters of the way through the first set. This time they led for most of the first set, and Brazil has seen enough early doors. They've gone for the timeout. They are hoping that this works because they'll have nothing left after the technical timeout.
This team does a great job communicating with one another. They're very clean, very respectful, and just
very relaxed.
yeah, considering the pressure. Very good information that goes across.
Yeah, I'm not sure there's much that Valkenhorst and Ludwig can say to each other because it doesn't get much better right now for them.
Yeah, you know, a conversation at a timeout like that could just go as simple as, hey, you do you. Trust it. Trust what you're doing because they're in the groove. They're in the zone.
Well, that's what Agatha and Barbara are trying to break by calling this timeout. Nothing more than just trying to make your opponent sweat it out for a period of time on the bench. Oh, dearie me.
Jeez.
That is incredible. That is, what, 3 in this set? 4 in this set? I think it's 3 now.
It's going to be imperative as they switch to the good side. A 6-1 switch. Anything past a 4-3 switch, if you can get a 5-2, that's a bonus ball. A 6-1, wow. You're closing in on a set pretty quickly if that's what you can keep up and you can get strung together.
Well, we've seen some extraordinary turnarounds in this competition thus far, so I wouldn't just write the Brazilians off too quickly.
No doubt about it. And they're on the good side now, so who's to say what those players are actually feeling down there as far as wind is concerned. Sometimes just that switch will give you a little boost of confidence, like, okay, we all right.
There you go.
Wow. And they switch it up and they go after Valkenhorst. But when Germany's on that side, they have been pounding Barbara. So there's something telling me that that corner might be the tough quad.
Difficult conditions for these players. Look at the flag there. Not as proud or tugging as hard as it once was, but it's still pretty breezy down there. Valkenhorst keeps cool, cuts it cross court, 7-3.
If I was Germany at this point, I'd be prepared for a back set. That has been working for Brazil. They like to go to that because that's a bit of their bailout, is to run the defense around.
Second ball finds the open court, and it's a little bit healthier from a Brazilian point of view now, 4-7. Valkenhorst
hangs
tough again to make yet another block. That's 6 in the match. She's won nearly half their points in this set with blocks. Of course, 4 blocks in set 2 for Valkenhorst. Call from the second referee, wasn't it?
Valkenhorst with a net violation. But Germany set that play up extremely well to put Laura Ludwig in a great defensive position.
Germany. Hey,
That side of the net has created three net violations. This one goes against Brazil. But what Brazil has done is they've switched sides. Agatha is now on the right side, Babara on the left. And they are still going after Babara, which is her non-dominant side because she's a lefty. She handles it well. But that indicates to me that if you divide the court into fourths, crossways, longways, that the quadrant that Agatha started on is probably the one most difficult to receive.
Good wow. Dig, excellent dig. Can she finish it off? No, because Ludwig is there. The set is too high, or too deep to the net. Another excellent rally, but it's another point to Germany. And right now they are looking pretty unstoppable.
A heck of a dig by Babara right here. Germany still staying aggressive with their setting, just waiting for their opportunity to score.
Cross court finds the mark.
Squeezed it just past Valkenhorst. In 2013, she was both the most improved and top rookie. In 3 years, here she is.
Real power from Valkenhorst. Oh, she's been digging well, Barbara, but no reply to that. So that's the technical timeout, and Germany are really in the box seat here. They took the first set against Larissa and Talita, 21-18. They've taken the first set here tonight in the final, 21-18. They won the second set in the semi-final, 21-12. You'd be surprised if the second set here is 21-12, but they are in the box seat there. The favourites right now, and Valkenhorst has just been blocking for fun here.
The German women are bringing such good energy, and it's authentic. They're not forcing celebrations. They're staying within themselves. It's really, really a beautiful game that they've put together over this last quad, and we get a glimpse of their brilliance just here in a brief moment of all the work that has been developed.
So, Barbara to serve. She and Agatha right up against it here. Set down, 8-13 down. Valkenhorst, oh yes, that is fantastic, but the set is too strong. And poor old Barbara comes up with one of the best digs we've seen in probably the whole tournament. And then it's overset.
What a layout. Comes right back at him.
Threads it down that channel.
Oh,
going hard. Again, I say it continues, I guess. Good dig once again. And off the block, and they are fighting every point here, Agatha and Barbara.
You know, we talk about timing and spacing and how imperative it is, but the angles of this game are ever shifting. And then you throw the element of the wind in. It can change the ball so drastically in the flight. So it is fascinating and brilliant that Barbara is in the right position more often than not.
Falkenhorst as well to control that serve, and then has the presence of mind just to cut it.
Just drops it. That is a great presence of mind.
Yep, good work.
Good communication by the Brazilians. Baba to talk to Agatha into just going over the block. Didn't need to be sharp, it just needed to be where Laura Ludwig was not.
Oh, she's kept it alive, Ludwig.
She stayed with it.
They're back to within three. Great speed across the sand.
Agatha keeping it simple. Good timeout by Germany.
Now, we are edging towards the final throws of the second set. Is it the final throws of the match? Brazil starting to eat into that deficit that came in the first 7 points.
You can kind of see a lower like mouthpiece on Agatha and Barbara. There's been so many studies in sports psychology and whatnot, sports science, sports medicine. Clenching of the teeth actually releases the drug cortisol into the brain, which is your fight or flight drug. Breathing calms you down. These athletes are so dialed in to what their numbers are, whether they need to get more excited or whether they need to calm down. Overexcitement causes issues. Too relaxed causes issues. Psychologically, knowing where you're at, knowing where you're running, some players need to calm down, therefore they breathe. Some players need to get amped up, so then they can clinch.
16-12. Just slides wide. Germany led 12-6, so Brazil, but won 7 of the last 10 points. If they could do the same again, then they would get their nose in front before the end of the set. Look at the win there, taking the set back and then curling the ball away. Good adjustment from Falkenhorst.
Exactly, and they have, I had mentioned their high set that they've been sticking with, working on, and executing extremely well. They're having to completely abandon that and go to a lower tempo set because the wind is now involved.
Well, the wind just killed that serve as well. And just as I talked about Brazil getting back into it, 2 points. Look at that. That has just died on Agatha. You've got to keep believing here, Brazil, though, because just as quickly as Germany ran out into that early lead, Brazil might have a late run. Look at that set, the wind. And this is getting very ominous now for Brazil.
So important to just stay low, take that step up, get that ball into the air, and play a tempo ball. Look how far up Agatha stepped. Oh, you're kidding me.
Well, they kept it alive, but they couldn't get it back over the net. And it's 7 gold medal points for Germany. Well, I said I didn't think they'd win the second set 21-12. They might well win it 21-13, but another great block from Valkenhorst. And this is it, the first of 7 gold medal points. Photographers scramble for position. And they'll have to wait a little longer.
Ludwig was on that. Overran, she was 2 on it.
The second match point comes on Brazil's serve.
No.
It's wide and it's all
question.
Over. Germany are the Olympic champions. They have taken the gold medal match by 2-0, 21-18, 21-14. And they are the Olympic champions in Rio. A thoroughly deserved title for the German pairing. Lara Ludwig and Kira Valkenhorst, the number 4 seeds, have defeated the number 2 seeds. The European champions have beaten the world champions. And as always, in situations like this, there are the two sides of the coin. The joy of the winners and the despair of the losers. But ironically, the Germans were more pumped after their semi-final win than they look here. I'm sure deep down that's not the case. Utter respect from both sets of players to each other. But a wonderful performance by Germany. They have been the team of the tournament, really. They have looked excellent throughout. They have lost just 1 set in the entire tournament.
They have left no doubt in the entire world's mind that they are the best team on planet Earth. They have put in the time, they have put in the hours. Not that anyone else in this competition didn't, but they were surgical. They left no question that they deserve to be on that gold medal podium. They've beat the best of the best of the best. It has been an entire journey. And those tears right there that you see from Agatha and Babada should not be out of disappointment or loss, but the fact that they committed so brilliantly to the entire journey themselves, that every point of this journey from the beginning of Olympic qualification till now has been brilliantly played and wonderfully executed. It just happens to be Germany that was unbelievable, unbeatable, and so, so dang good.
So Brazil's wait for Olympic gold medal in the women's competition goes on for another 4 years at least. The German pairing of Ludwig and Valkenhorst created history by making the final and winning their country's first ever medal in women's beach volleyball. Well, they've gone one better. It's an historic gold for Germany. And this is the match stats. And while the attacks, look at that, the Brazilians have more. But really, there was only ever one team in it in that second set. And it's the team in your screen right now. The German number 4 seeds. They beat the number 1 seeds in the semi-final. They beat the number 2 seeds in the final. And for good measure, they beat the number 5 seeds in the quarterfinals. You cannot say they don't deserve it because they have come up against the best and they've sent them all packing. You feel for Agatha and Barbara, so much expected of them. They couldn't repeat their performance of their semi-final when they beat the American pairing of April Ross and Kerry Walsh Dennings in a quite brilliant match. So much expectation on them, but it wasn't to be.
What we've seen is when these matches have been decided, it has been no question.
Mesdames et messieurs, la cérémonie des vainqueurs du volleyball de plage féminin.
Now it's on, ladies and gentlemen. The victory ceremony for women's beach volleyball.
Senhoras e senhores, a cerimônia de premiação do vôlei de praia feminino.
So welcome back to Copacabana Beach for the victory ceremony for the women's beach volleyball competition.
Please welcome the medalists.
Por favor, deem as boas-vindas às medalhistas.
Well, what a competition it has been here on Copacabana, the adopted home of beach volleyball. But it isn't Brazil on top of the podium. It's a new nation. It's Germany. But first, the bronze medals. And, well, what a team they have been, but what a player.
Les médailles seront remises par Madame
we have in Kerry Walsh Jennings.
Membre de la commission exécutive
but first,
du
the
Comité
medal presenters.
Olympienne, une médaille de bronze, accompagnée du docteur
Miss Anita Filho, de France from the United States of America.
The medals will be presented rowing by Miss
the Olympic Games.
De France, United States of America,
and the gifts by Dr. Ali Garcia Filho from Brazil,
Olympian,
the president of the International Volleyball Federation.
Ari Graça Filho, president of International Volleyball Federation, Brazil.
As medalhas serão entregues pela senhora Anita de France, Estados Unidos da América, membro do Comitê Executivo do Comitê Olímpico Internacional, atleta olímpica, uma medalha de bronze, acompanhada pelo Dr. Ari Graça Filho, Brasil, presidente da Federação Internacional de Voleibol.
Medalha de bronze, representando os Estados Unidos da América.
Bronze medalists, representing United States of America.
Medalha de bronze, representando os Estados Unidos da América, Kerry Walsh Jennings e April Ross.
Kerry Walsh Jennings on the left as we look, and April Ross. What a performance by them. They were dead and buried in that bronze medal match, but dug deep and somehow managed to get over the line. What a career Kerry Walsh Jennings has had. Three times Olympic gold medalist, and this is her reaction to her fourth Olympic medal, a bronze. And April Ross, who lost to Kerry Walsh Jennings in the London final, picks up her second medal with a silver, and there are tears all round.
Beautiful. Absolutely beautiful. Just staying in the fight.
And what a reception they are getting from the crowd.
They did America very, very proud.
It just goes to show, it doesn't matter how many Olympic medals you win, each one is just as special.
It tells a story that's bigger and more than we could ever know.
What a journey it has been for Kerry Walsh Jennings. But now the silver medalists.
Silver
Barbara
medalists
is very upset.
Representing Brazil.
Medalha de prata, representando o Brasil. Agatha Benatzuk e Barbara Seixas.
Agatha and Barbara. Agatha enjoying the situation. Barbara's trying, but she is very, very upset.
There's a whole lot of emotion that goes in it. I think they're feeling a little bit of everything. These guys have come in and they were the first to solidify their spot in the Olympics by being the world champs. They know how to win. They've done it many times over. And they too have done their country extremely proud. They fought very, very good, valiant warriors right there.
In the last 12 months, or since they've won the World Championship, they haven't won a tournament. They've only been second twice on the World Tour. So they came into this, they didn't come into this Olympic Games with any real form. So while Barbara may be disappointed because she had a shot at gold, but she didn't quite get that, what they've achieved on the form that they had coming into this is exceptional, and she will enjoy that later, if not right now. I think Agatha's enjoying it.
Médaillée d'or et championne olympique représentant l'Allemagne.
Gold medalists and Olympic champions, Germany.
Medalha de ouro e campeãs olímpicas representando a Alemanha, Laura.
Absolutely beautiful.
Well, the Germans came into this one as one of the form teams. In the last 12 months, they've won five competitions. They've come second on one occasion and third on two occasions. They won the A1 major in Klagenfurt a week before these games started, so they came in bang on form. They've won three of their last five before the Olympic Games. There is no doubt that they are worthy Olympic champions. Tears on every step of this beach volleyball podium. What a fantastic performance by the pair from Germany. When the chips were down, when they faced the top seeds, they performed, and they performed again.
Such beautiful spirits get the gold tonight. Wonderful, wonderful women, wonderful people, incredible athletes and players. And Germany, Germany gets gold. Believe it.
So now that the medals have been presented, we will rise for the national anthem of Germany. The first time it's being played out in the women's beach volleyball at the Olympic Games.
O hino da Alemanha.
It makes the hairs on the back of your neck stand up. A wonderful moment for Laura Ludwig and Kira Valkenhorst. They are the Olympic champions. And such camaraderie between all three pairs. We'll have the usual photograph on the top step of the podium. But those are your medalists at the 2016 Rio Olympic Games. Bronze to Walsh, Jennings and Ross. Silver to Agatha and Barbara. Gold to Ludwig and Valkenhorst.